the Lisa Show.
While sometimes we throw around the term like narcissist for obnoxious behavior, it is a real condition. And narcissistic personality disorder is medically defined as when a person has an inflated sense of self-importance. Narcissism can, without help, can really lead to not just damaging whoever's struggling, but those around them. And the hard part is many people don't realize their partner is even a narcissist. Well, today we'll be talking with licensed marriage and family therapist Darlene Lancer about the abuse of narcissistic behavior. And she's an expert author on relationships and codependency, having written books like Codependency for Dummies and Dealing with a Narcissist. Welcome, Darlene. Thank you for being here.
Oh, I appreciate the opportunity to educate your audience. So thank you.
Well, I appreciate you being willing to be here. And when we talk about narcissism and this inflated sense of self, we throw a lot of terms around. And I thought maybe we could begin by talking about some of the false stereotypes that of narcissists that should be addressed before we get into their relationship with other people.
Oh, that's a good idea. Some people think that because their partner brags a lot or because they are selfish, that's like a key word, that they must be narcissistic. Well, there's a lot more to the personality disorder than someone who's selfish or brags. Someone just might be insecure and they brag a lot or self-centered. And also, if they seem to lack empathy, that's not necessarily a narcissist. There are a lot of other reasons why a person may not be empathetic. So there are a number of characteristics that a person has to have. Lack of empathy is one of them, and a grandiose sense of self. But you need like 5 of 9 characteristics to qualify for having a personality disorder. So it's more than that.
And when we're talking about narcissism and a diagnosis, is that something that has to be done through a psychologist or a psychiatrist?
Well, a marriage and family therapist can also do that, but it should be a professional.
And so, to me, as we are engaging with those that we think might be narcissistic, I think it's a long haul to be like, hey, come with me to a therapist. Yeah. I want to find out if you're narcissistic or have narcissism.
Well, one of the things you should not do is label a narcissist. If it is a narcissist, labeling is going to be counterproductive because they're going to go on the attack. And the one thing that narcissists do is they will never take responsibility for anything because underneath all of their braggadocio is a very fragile ego. They never let anything crack their armor. They have this facade of being perfect because they think they have to be perfect to compensate for the inadequacy and shame that's underneath. And so they can never take responsibility and they will go on the attack, maybe call you a narcissist or blame you for something. It's not going to be effective. And usually they're not interested in therapy, couples therapy or individual therapy, because they don't want to reveal them.
It doesn't seem like a very attractive trait. Why are people attracted to narcissists?
Well, it's interesting that they have a lot of charisma usually, and they're very good at managing other people, psyching them out, and using certain skills that they have to attract people. For instance, praise them, seduce them, flatter them. That's one of their first tactics, to draw people to them because they want people to like them. But some research has shown that it might take 7 visits with the person before you start to see who they are and not like them. They did research and people interviewed with narcissists, and generally they liked the person until around the 7th meeting, and then they started to dislike the person. So it takes a while for you to be able to see through the veneer of how charming they are. So they do a lot of, it's what's called impression management, to gain status with someone and to make you like them. They have good conversational skills. They might be very witty. They promote themselves, they boast, they brag, and people are drawn to that.
If you're just joining the conversation, we're visiting with Darlene Lancer, who is a licensed marriage and family therapist, about narcissists and about those that would be impacted by narcissists. Interesting to me as we continue the conversation about knowing if a person is a narcissist, if people are listening to this and they're thinking, oh, you know, maybe I am, it's when you talk about what a narcissist would do with the information, that they would be narcissistic, they would lean against that information and be that much harder to be diagnosed. This seems to be one of the more difficult sort of disorders within within personality to be able to help. Is that the case? And if so, how do we help a narcissist?
Well, that is true. Personality disorders are considered enduring. So they start in childhood or in your teens, it becomes more noticeable. And because a personality disorder is who they've been for so long, they don't really feel like something is wrong with them. It's not like I'm feeling depressed, I don't feel like myself. Even someone who is bipolar has another personality that is healthy. But someone with a personality disorder, it's considered enduring, meaning they don't notice something is off. In fact, they distort reality to match their inner reality. So everything is projected out there, that the problem is out there. And they feel okay within themselves. It feels like normal to them who they are. And they don't want to go to therapy. And so that makes it hard to change. But if you try to educate them rather than criticize them in a way that's not condescending, but to let them know that when you did such and such, it really didn't work out well for you, because primarily they're interested in how they feel. You let them know sometimes the impact of their behavior hurts them themselves. Like if they want someone to like them, but then they're aggressive, it's counterproductive to their goals. So they think very transactionally. Hmm. Probably you've heard that phrase, that they're only transactional in their relationships. So they want to know what's in it for them. So if you phrase things in, well, this behavior, what you did, is going to be counterproductive to what you're trying to achieve, then it gets their attention rather than you hurt my feelings. How could you do that? You're so inconsiderate. That they will take as a criticism, and they will go on the offense to defend themselves.
Why do some narcissists go undetected?
Because they're so charming, and they're skilled at knowing your weaknesses or how you're going to respond. Sometimes they will mirror you. You like you go on a date with them, and you like certain food or certain interest, and they might mirror that and say, oh, that's exactly the same thing I like. And they'll try to manage you that way. And the other thing is they generally avoid too much intimacy or situations where they're not going to shine. Mm-hmm. They prefer a hierarchical environment where they can rise to the top rather than where they're going to be equal. A setting where they can't get status, where it's frowned upon, where they're supposed to have teamwork. They'd rather be in a competitive environment where they can be better than someone else. So, and they're always scanning the surroundings and other people to see, where do I stand? Am I one up on someone? Am I one down? And then they have to correct for that. So they're very hypervigilant to their status and how to influence people, how to get attention, how to get praise relative to the competition. So if they go into a room, they want to scan who is the competitor there, how can they look good, who can they impress. They're constantly thinking that way, like very political and what their status is.
Early in this discussion, you talked about the danger of labeling someone narcissistic. I want to take that a little bit further out in the conversation. Within just our every day to day, we would say, oh, you're such a narcissist. You're being narcissistic. You know, we sort of throw that term around.
Mm-hmm.
What do you feel like is the danger in that sort of speak?
First of all, if you're criticizing someone, you're not going to be effective for your relationship. To label someone, it's actually considered invasive, because now you're labeling them and telling them who they are. Mm-hmm. So that in itself can be considered abusive. But there's something called narcissistic traits or narcissistic tendencies. And that's not a full-blown personality disorder. But if you want to improve the relationship, it's going to be more effective if you say, you know, I'm feeling like I don't matter in the relationship, or I feel like my needs don't matter to you. And then that's being more assertive rather than starting off with you this or you that, and letting the person know how you feel and take responsibility for your own feelings rather than labeling them. Maybe you didn't communicate what you needed. And a lot of times people think the other person should read their mind, that they shouldn't have to express their needs and wants. And then they feel not heard or not valued, but they never let the other person know exactly what they need and want.
Darlene Lancer, a licensed marriage and family therapist, an expert author on relationships and also codependency. You can learn more about her work by going to whatiscodependency.com. Darlene, thanks for being with us.